Hello.
Everything is okay. You sound great. You sound great.
I'm sound good. Thank you very much. Okay. Is it really Filip Ivanov? Can I show you? Yeah.
Hello.
Well, anyway, it's almost time to start. But we'll wait a couple of minutes. Hi, everybody. Nice to see you. Hi, Vanya. Hi, Filip. If it is you, if it is not your daddy. Okay, 1 minute. Слушай, экран. Andrew, please. I need my screen to be shown to everybody.
Yes, you can do it. Try again. I share your screen.
Well, it tells me that organizer cancel. I try.
Okay. Let's try again this.
Okay, now it's better. Well, now it's fine. Okay, let me start. I'm glad to see you, and today Rakurs Technical Support Department is going to make a webinar, which is divided actually into two parts. The first part is dedicated to a new version of PhotoMod software. It has a number 7.1, and it was released a couple of months ago. And we'll talk about new functions. And then the next part is about a relatively new software called PhotoMod Auto UAS. As you can see from the name, it is used for automatic processing of data from unmanned aerial vehicles. I am Dmitry Kochergin, and I'm head of Rakurs Technical Support Department. Also, Eugen Brusnikin will take part in our webinar. So, my colleague from the same division. And so, let me start. Oops, excuse me. Okay, sorry. well, first couple of slides is kind of general. It's for those of you who maybe is not so familiar with PhotoMod. And so PhotoMod is digital photogrammetric system, as you can see from this picture. So, and it is developed in order to solve all tasks related with digital photogrammetry, from aerial triangulation and block adjustment till the building of output products, standard output products like digital elevation models, contour lines, 3D features, ortos, true ortos, and digital maps, and 3D models, which is very popular. So we have images of different nature, satellite images, aerial images, UAV images, and PhotoMod is able to make the output products I have mentioned a minute ago. Well, also I should tell you that last time we do not consider PhotoMod as just a software product. It's more a kind of platform which combines solutions, hardware solutions, software solutions, point cloud solutions, network, etc., etc., and used for the main goal to make a kind of production line and big cartographic mapping enterprises. And you can see it on this picture. Well, let's go back to 7.1. The main new features. The first one is AutoUAS, new software for automatic processing of UAC images, but we will talk about it later in more details. Stereo server, stereo client is the application for remote work and professional stereo mode. And also some features basically used for make our software faster and more accurate, related with point cloud calculation, aerial triangulation, and etc. Some illustrations for the previous slide. This is an interface of AutoUAS software, but as I already told you, we'll talk about it a bit later. So let's go to the next one. Stereo server, stereo client. The idea is that we have a server somewhere, and the PhotoMod project is installed on this server, and we also have several client workplaces, and they are really remote workplaces since they're can be located in different buildings, in different cities, and even in different countries. And we have tested this technology for different workplaces like Moscow, Berlin, Moscow, Ural Mountains, Moscow, Siberia, Moscow, Far East. And usually everything was basically fine. The operators were able to work comfortably in professional, as I already said, in professional stereo mode and page flipping. And it's clear that now it is very useful because the situation with this pandemic thing, a lot of people work remotely, and here in Rakurs we have made several projects also completely remotely based on this technology. And another advantage is probably to make a training when the teacher is on the server place and the students are on the client workplaces, and they are able to make projects and work in stereo, since it's very important for photogrammetry. Well, some more samples of new features, flights of any complexity level. A lot of flights look like this, flights from UAV, from aerial unmanned vehicles, very complicated, big angles of pitch and row, so it's not easy for the algorithms to find the tie points, and we still make some improvements in this area. And it's a sample of basically the same thing. It's a project combined from two flights. The first one is Nadir from DJI camera, and another one is Oblique from Supercam camera. And you can see that we were able to make a model working with them all together. And this is Palmyra in Syria, 3D model of this architecture monument, partially destroyed. Acceleration sample is pretty clear. Well, 3.5 hours in 7.0, 1 hour in 7.1, of course, on the same project, on the same hardware configuration. And new presets, it's parameters of tie point measurements. We have got new presets called optimal, exact, multi-time, and also the old one from PhotoMod 6.5. Parameters are hidden from customer, but it can be edited if necessary. Multi-time images improvements. Again, about AT, we are still talking about aerial triangulation. As you know, sometimes we have to make a projects based on images from different time, from different days, sometimes even from different seasons. So we made some improvements for this kind of projects. And by the way, we already have samples that were not processed in 6.5 and were processed in 7.1. So of course it's very good. A bit more in details for each module of PhotoMod system. I am not ready to read all of them. I think you can do it yourself. As I said before, basically it's about improvements in acceleration and improvements in the accuracy of output product. And of course, some new features like, support of some new cameras, some new default parameters in aerial triangulation. For example, the ratio between focal length and basis. Now it is calculated based from the nature of survey, and it is different for aerial images and UAV images, and so on. So some improvements working on several cameras in one project, automatic measurements of ground control points taken from reference ortho image, automatic pyramid level selection independence of the image size. It's also very important because sometimes images are very small and we have to use another pyramid level in comparison with huge images from professional cameras. again, some illustration block connection analysis means that sometimes algorithm for some reason is not able to find ties between different parts of the block, and this new tool is very visible. I mean, it's easy to find which part is not connected and make a decision actually what to do. Maybe add some manual type point measurements or restart automatic type point measurement with another set of parameters and so on. Sorry, some new features for satellite imagery, preliminary adjustment based on GCPs, support of new sensor of Pleiades Neo, and so on. Regarding the digital elevation models, again, the speed and accuracy, dividing block clouds, point clouds into fragments, which is speeding up the process. Some improvements in distributed processing of loss of LAS blocks creation if the number of tasks is more than 500. Undo for DM editing operation, because it's very useful. So on. You can read the full list of items relating to digital elevation models, batch import, volume calculation improvements, and so on. Point cloud filter, new point cloud filter. Now we are talking about photogrammetry point cloud. It is not cloud coming from board. It is a cloud calculated by PhotoMod software now. So in previous versions, we make some post-processing of point clouds in order to filter noise. Now everything is embedded into the process of digital surface model creation and point cloud creation. And we have changed the default parameters, and by our opinion, got much more efficiency. And the sample, it's easy to see that the left part of slide contains noise, and the right part almost without the noise in the point cloud. 3D modeling. Again, you can read the items, some new filters, some new algorithms of filling holes, fast algorithm of filling holes. Again, it is fast. And batch export, some changes in mesh building algorithm, capability to make simple measurements over 3D model, and 3D creation from ADS data, and so on. Sample of TIN simplification, the idea is clear that you have a lot of triangles in the left image, and you have not so many triangles in the right image, but keeping the same accuracy of the model. So it's the same by precision point, but it can be described by less number of triangles. And of course, it's critical because of huge volumes of data used for 3D models. Improvements in true order. We are still working on to make the color balancing more perfect than in current version. So got some improvements in this case, and we are still working on this. I believe it will be better in the next version. Also, we have supported 4 channels, through Orta for 16-bit source rasters. 3D feature extraction. Well, there was a project for digitizing of roofs, but the final output product was not a polygon of roof, it was a 3D model. So we add a feature that allowed us to connect polygons during the 3D vectorization. As a result, we always have one 3D object as output. I mean, one roof, one object. In previous version, the roofs were divided into several polygons while the vectorization. Some new features and improvements in embedding bridges into the output Orta mosaic, and something else in all parts of photo mode and project creation and import export, some new formats of import export, new coordinate systems, and so on. Oh, well, this picture basically for Russian customers, because a new geo calculator almost has no, almost the same for everybody except Russian customers. But anyway, the advantage for all of us, for all of you, is that a bit later, the PhotoMod system and the PhotoMod geocalculator will work with the same database of coordinates. For now, probably you know that we have to make some complicated things, create a system in calculators and import it to PhotoMod and so on. So of course it's not really convenient. So now we'll get rid of this problem. Actually, I'm done with the first part. So if you have any questions, you can ask it to the microphone or type it out in our chat. I will read it and I will answer.
Thank you for the nice presentations. Am I audible?
Hey, I hear you.
Okay. So, once again, thank you. Basically, I was trying to understand, like, when you said that it is fully automated, what is the basic input we require? Is it geotagged images? I missed.
You mean source images for PhotoMode projects?
Yes, for the
It's just well images in any popular format and TIFF, no, whatever JPEG, any kind of images. If you're talking about satellite images, we support every each specific format of satellite images. For aerial images, is usually it is very. It's just standard formats like GeoTIFF with exterior orientation parameters, even without them, JPEGs.
Okay, I was just trying to understand that the photos has to be geotagged, isn't it? Geotagged means it should have the central coordinates.
I can ask actually.
Means the central coordinates must be tagged with the photo?
Well okay. You mean the coordinates of projection centers, right?
Yes, of the UAV photos collected.
Well, for now, almost any aerial survey is done with this exterior orientation parameters, with projection centers, with angles, but it's not obligatory thing. If you do not have them, we can process the block without them. But last time, I don't know, 99.99% of data is accompanied with this exterior orientation parameters. And of course, you can use also ground control points. And in many cases, it is much more accurate than the centers on board centers.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I got a question from Filippa, our old friend from Italy. Hello, everyone. My question, can I use image without data set EXIF? For example, not professional camera. Well, actually, it's almost the same question like it was before. Of course, it's much better to have exterior orientation parameters, whether they are in EXIF section of JPEG or in some separate file, text file. But if you do not have them, we can try to process the block without them. But in this case, of course, you will need points on the ground for georeference your images. Camera for UAV cameras usually are not professional, of course. So we make self-calibration to make them more professional. So it's a very typical situation. But the coordinates of centers are getting more and more accurate last time because of the systems installed on board of UAV. Ken, two questions. The first one: can we use images from? Can we use images from MicaSense multispectral bands? Question from Balin.
MicroSense is the
MicroSense.
Yeah, five bands.
Yeah. Yes, of course. There is no. Well, we have some details about multi-band images, and. But yes, it's possible.
Okay.
Possible, okay. Because, for example, infrared channel is a very typical situation. It's four bands already. Sometimes it can be five bands.
Okay, thank you.
And even more in the case of satellite images, for example, like WorldView, 2-8 bands, as far as I remember. Filippo, one more question. How you test for facade? It's not completely clear what is t- test, but we can texture facades, of course, and there are several approaches of texturing of facades taken from point cloud or from just DSM model. Andras, do you have possibility to regenerate true world and 3D mesh after some editing corrections of automatically generated DSM? It's a good question. For now, we make true world and 3D mesh at the same time with DSM. So in fact, it will be rebuilding for everything. So we make DSM again. At the same time, we make true ortho. But we do not need any time for true ortho creation. We need just to make a DSM and true ortho will be created automatically. But we have plans, we have a feature in our wish list, which tells something like make a model by using external DSM or external point cloud. So we will have the capability having the PhotoMod project, load external point of cloud, load external DSM and make texturing for them. But it will, as I said, it will be, because for now everything is all together. We have a PhotoMod project and we make DSM and we make true ortho at the same time. Anything else? Well, if there are no questions, there are no more questions, probably we'll switch to the second part of webinar, and it will be about PhotoMod Auto UAS. But first I will show you this software interface, and then we'll switch to a small presentation with the samples of output products. And, okay, this is, should I show the screen again? Okay, thank you. Sent my colleague. One more question, sorry. I have a question about postal swoggles. I have a question about monitors for stereoscopic view. Can you suggest a monitor and glasses? As you probably know, there are two main types of stereo equipment. The first one is a polarization monitor, and it is, by my opinion, is the best solution. It is the most professional thing. And in Russia, there are some enterprises that make these monitors, but I'm not sure about exporting them abroad. If to talk about Europe, there is a German company, Schneider company, that produce these monitors, and you can use them. Well, another option is to use shutter glasses and high frequency monitor. But for now, got a problem with the glasses, with this new vision technology, with drivers for this kind of equipment. So it still exists, but every time it's kind of problem to find this combination of hardware. High 120 hertz monitor and the glasses because as I said, there is no production line for now. So we are trying to find them all the time somewhere on the market. I don't know in Avito and so on. So of course the best way is the first polarization monitor. It is more more expensive, of course, but it is more professional at the same time. So probably Schneider in Europe is the best way to work in stereo. Is it possible? Is it Shiraz Ahmed? Is it possible to export Photomod project file to Trimble Info project file? Yes, it's possible, but it's not a kind of file. There are several ways to export a photogrammetric project to another software. The first one, when you export camera parameters and exterior orientation parameters in some easy format like XYZ omega phi kappa for exterior orientation and some format for camera. Another way, if info user just to make the same camera in his system and import exterior orientation parameters from this simple text file. Also, we can export measurements. We can export measurements of tie points by using some popular formats, like probably PAD-B is the best way. So yes, it's possible. It's possible. Usually we make import actually. Sometimes we need import from another software, from Info. Again, we import camera, we import exterior orientation parameters to continue job in Photomod, for example, in stereo. But export is also possible. It's not so common situation. Now they see the screen. Okay. So hopefully you can see my screen. At least Andrew and Alex can see it, I believe, because they keep silence. So let's go back to Photomod Auto US. Can they see everything? Or
yes.
Or just small? Okay. Okay, this is an interface. As I already told several times, it's very easy, it's very simple, it's very small. It contains of just two tablet pages. The first one, general, used for entering the project name, selecting a folder with source images, selecting processing method, fast, precise, or optimal. Optimal is probably most common thing because it's kind of compromise between speed and accuracy. Also, you can select the temporary data folder and the output folder. And what is also interesting that the temporary data folder actually contains Photomod project. So if you are not satisfied with the automatic procedure with the data you have got from this Auto UAS, you can start Photomod, load this project, and make any manual measurements or any manual improvements you want on every step of processing, and bundle adjustment and measurements and everywhere. But it is kind of intermediate data, so this option should be off if you want to keep the Photomod project, if you do not want to delete them. And you have enough space on your disk. Settings is close to output. So the first tab is input actually. This one is more for output. What's interesting here, TrueWord and DSM, so our output products. You can select how do you want to divide the output products. Do you actually want to divide, or you can keep it in one sheet for the total project? We can divide it into 1 kilometer sheets. And this part is for output product selection. Have two choices. First one is what we call 3D model. Actually, it is DSM and TrueVorta. And another one is complete 3D tin. It is textured tin. So the first one is kind of fast output product, and the second one is complete output product. In case of second one, you can also select the format Collado on B3DM. Also, you can use the option save 3D to Cesium in order to publish it in the web immediately. You can use GPU. If the card is okay for this purpose, you can set this option. Well, that's it. So you select images, you select output product, you select folders, click on start processing data. Also I have to say that the software will use all resources of the computer you use for AutoUAS. So all cores will be involved in the processing. So distributed processing will be used automatically. And after, as soon as the project is done, you can see immediately the output, the results. For example, this is DSM, digital surface models, and TrueVorta. And TrueVorta, it can be displayed. Can be displayed immediately in some special window. You do not need photo mode for this purpose. You have to. The window is open directly in AutoUAS, and also. For also you can see the output 3D model. I will select another one because it's smaller, and it will be displayed faster, I believe. So for example, this is also output product of AutoUAS software. So everything depends on the accuracy of the source data. You have no capability to measure ground control points. So everything depends on the accuracy of your exterior orientation parameters, basically of the projection centers. And so the output accuracy will correspond to the input accuracy. Well, now a very small presentation. We make this experiments, pictures, not pictures, but models, right yesterday. So this is my PowerPoint. Why, sorry, it's another one. So. So this is illustrations of quality and productivity, and also samples of kind of output 3D models. So this is what I called 3D tin. It is a complete product, and this is 3D model. You can see that there is no textures on the walls, and it is just DSM plus TrueVorta. This one is DSM plus point cloud, texturing, etc., etc. So everything is completely done over here, including the walls. And of course, this one is faster, this one is slower, and the estimation of productivity for this project is over here. So preset, I told you about presets, is optimal. And by the way, yes, optimal means it is two GSD in comparison with the source data. Precise is one GSD and fast is four GSD. So for this all products, output products is 2 hours, 42 minutes. For fast, oh, sorry, it's, of course it is fast one, 3D model, which we call 3D model is this one, this is 2 hours, 40 minutes, and complete 3D textured tin is about 5 hours. And the hardware is like this, 4 cores and 32 gigabytes of RAM. Just some more samples of the same project. Again, it is a 3D tin, complete full 3D tin. You can see, for example, this church with windows, with walls, with everything. Here it looks like this, but for some purposes, this picture is enough, because originally the Photomod UAS were developed for for different purposes, including, for example, military, which need some fast operative results. The productivity is exactly the same because it is the same project, just a bit more samples. Just zoom it in. Again, complete tin with complete textures and 3D model calculated from DSM and TrueWorld. The same church, same buildings around it. Another sample, it's already 1,200 images. Of course, time taken is bigger, 11 hours for complete model and 6 hours for fast model. And also we use here a bit different hardware because RAM is already 96 gigabytes and the number of cores is 13 and 26 virtual cores. The last sample. So I am actually done with the second presentation. Again, we are ready for questions.
Thank you once again for the nice presentation. It was nice. I just could, in what format can we expect to export to the orthophoto?
Orthophoto. So orthophoto is just again, as I told already, pretty standard format, GeoTIFF basically, or some TIFFs with different kind of georeference.
Okay, we can export it from the same interface.
The same what? Sorry.
From the within the software, from the software, we can export it.
Yes. It's not even export. It's just an immediate result. We save order to GeoTIFF basically. We do not use some kind of internal format for orthophoto and photomod. We made order rectification immediately to some output formats, basically GeoTIFF.
Okay. Thank you.
It's more complicated situation with 3D models actually, because there is no real standard for 3D model, and all customers want. Each customer wants another output format, so it's more complicated situation. SGB, JSON, etc., 3DDM. But in case of ORT, everything is easy, clear.
Right.
Next question: how many images we can process on the project file? Well, last project, yes, we got one time we got kind of problem because we need to process 200,000 images, and we divide this project into four. Each project contains of 50,000 images, 50, because it was a kind of problem on the stage of bundle adjustment. So we make them separately, then we contain them all together. But on the stage of bundle adjustment, it was 50,000 images in one project. Oh, Yanis, I'm here. Out. It is, well, Auto US is standalone, or it is included in this? Yes, it's standalone software, but wait a second, I need some consultation. I'm not going to start it. Well, it's standalone. What's the maximal image size? It's from Yuri cost afterwards. You know the cost. Yuri, the maximal image size for Auto UAS has the same limitation as UAS. It's Photomod UAS, 100 megabytes. Megapixels. And the cost, we need to ask our commercial people. I'm not sure. Maybe Andrew will. Andrew is here. Maybe he will tell us the cost of Auto UAS.
2,900 USD.
2,900
USD.
So 3,000 approximately, right?
Yeah, right.
Okay, about 3,000. Well, from Balin, in case some manual editing is required, then two software should be, yes, of course, yes. Because Auto UAS is completely automatic, the idea was to make everything automatic. It's from two ideas, one button, and everything is automatic. If you need some manual things, you will need Photomod main system or Photomod UAS software. Yes, Photomod UAS is better because it's cheaper. Can external GCPs be used? Well, it's not completely clear for me. GCPs are always external.
Means we can put the external GCPs also, or only from.
Well, for example, we have a list of ground control points. You have sketches related to each of them. Of course, you can. Sorry, I'm always talk about several softwares at the same time. If we are talking about Auto UAFs, there is no way to add GCPs. No, only exterior orientation parameters. So it's very good to have exterior orientation parameters with high enough accuracy. Well, GCPs available only in Photomod UAS or in Photomod main program.
Right, okay.
Well, next question from Ignity Kalpuski. How you can map, vectorize the result of Auto UAS? Well, depends on what kind of result do you use. If it is true order, you can just load it into some GIS system and vectorize it. You can load it in Photomod, whatever. If we are talking about the 3D models, I don't know, probably you can also load it to some system, 3D model oriented system that has a capability of vectorization over this model. So there is no way to vectorize it in the auto UAS. But you can do it in Photomod, UAS. You can do everything there. Because again, the idea was to make everything automatically and easy. Can you optimize thin models so to reduce number of triangles? Yes, as I showed on one of my pictures, there are some settings that can allow you to reduce number of triangles. But of course, you should be accurate with this parameter, because the idea is to keep the accuracy on the same level and use less number of triangles. But the parameter exists while the 3D model creation. So, don't see. Will there be any light? Will there be any light version for evaluation? Again, it's a question about auto UAS, right? Because Photomod light version is available all the time. Light version of Photomod is available now. Oh, maybe people from our commercial department. Okay, Andrew has already replied. Please send us a request to test the program. And as far as I know, all participants of these webinars are able to get the test version for testing.
The time limited version is available for everyone.
What is the time limit? 2 minutes.
No, 30 days. 30 days. It's for you, for your data, for evaluation. And yes, of course, okay. For your feedback.
Okay. So as Andrew said, one month evaluation version is available for now. Okay, anything else? By the way, as far as we know, today is a holiday, a JS day. So my congratulations to all of you. At least I know that for Russia and Bulgaria, it is true, because I got congratulations from Bulgarian guys in the morning and from Russians also, of course. So we can extrapolate this holiday all over the world, all JS people.
Cheers.
You're welcome. Any questions?
The video record of the webinar will be available. So See you on our website or YouTube channel.
Yes, everything is recorded, hopefully. Hopefully we did not forget to push the appropriate button and record the video. Okay, thank you, Filippa. And of course, just nice to see you. Nice to see all our old friends.
Right, after a long time.
And of course, new friends also, but
yes,
friends are old friends anyway. So many years.
Excellent.
So, okay, we can finish probably. Oh.
Thank you so much.
Oh, yeah, it would be very nice to see you in Italy or Moscow or anywhere. Hi, Vanya. Exactly the same thing, old friends.
So, thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you very much, and hopefully we'll be back long time later. Well, several months. Okay, thank you.